Yes. Hello, my lord. This is Captain Keeler. I've been, assigned as your liaison with the attack group. Be assured that I am aware of your, strict policy regarding job performance. I won't let you down, my lord.
Alrighty, what's happening? This is Lightning Bolt Forever back again with the finale of Star Wars The Force Unleashed Ultimate Sith Edition. We have come a long way, and we are finally at the last bonus level here. We have landed on Hoth, and we must infiltrate Echo Base, the Rebels base. And all the events in this level take place during the events of The Empire Strikes Back, albeit with a little bit of an alternate storyline here. But anyway, let's head on down here. Before we do that, same as before, we have no secondary objective, 5 holocrons and 600,000 force points that, unfortunately, like the last level, are unattainable for this level, just because there aren't enough enemies in the level. And with that, yes, like I said, 5 holocrons. Everything is still maxed out, so we will just be collecting holocrons for completeness sake, just to show you where they all are. And as for the lightsaber, we're going to go ahead and gear up here once again with the Vextal Crystal. And we'll get right on to it. So let's head into the cave. Slide on down here and right on through here. And we're going to have... Whoa! We're going to have a Wampa. Or actually, not a Wampa. We're going to have many Wampas. But this is just the first. And yes, don't be fooled. This guy's on the ground right now. But he is... He's a heavy hitter. Look at all the bones. He's a heavy hitter. And you will see just how heavy. You can see what happens is, yep. Because when they... Yeah, watch out. Because when they... If they get enough of those spin attacks on you there, they can kill you easily without you ever even being able to recover. But with that, let's break through the sheet of ice here. And into the caverns we go. Let's see.
My lord, scanners are indicating that the ice caverns through which you travel may be a bit unstable. It seems the vibrations from our walkers may be partly to blame. It's possible that I overlooked this when planning your infiltration route.
You failed me for the last time, Captain Keena.
If that is the case, I assure you, I take full...
Oh, well, that's the end of Captain Keena. And, he screwed up. He stinks. He's got it. He's going to get punished for it. Although, why would he tell Starkiller that he even screwed up? He could just say, oh, the ice cavern is acting up. We don't know what's wrong. But no, he admitted fault. And yeah, he pretty much sealed his own fate there, so... But anyway, Holocron number 1 out of 5 is here. And yes, we've got all these pillars falling here, all these ice caps that are falling even without us touching them. So yeah, there's definitely a lapse in communication there. And let's see if we just can't just push these wampas off here. Away, yes, away with you foul beasts. Off we go. Don't need to worry about them. So let's head on this way.
Sir, this is Lieutenant Marston. I see that you've saved Captain Keena from duty. I'll be acting as your liaison with the battle group.
Excellent, we have a new liaison. Perfect, sir. Now, let's get these. We have a whole bunch of turrets in this little area here. And we're going to electrify them all with force lightning. Because that's the most effective way I've found of getting rid of them, other than the lightsaber, of course. And yes, just like that. And whoa, well, they looks like they shot a hole in the wall right here, so that actually works out perfectly. We can throw out the generator to the force field here, and that will allow us to get into Echo Base. Ah, and here come those rebels, that rebel scum. Those no good, dirty rebels. Increase fire, men! And yeah, this is basically no different than fighting Coda's militiamen in the second level of the game. Like, way back to the Thai construction yard here. But anyway, inside we go. And we're... Stand down? Excuse me. What were you thinking bringing a gun to a lightsaber fight here? I mean, come on, man. Anyway, we're just making fast, quick work of these guys. Oh, poor asteroid. Oh, well. We're making fast work of all these guys here. Zap him. And yes, we will press on and climb up our little ice staircase here. And we'll go this way. And, force field. So we must find another way. Yeah, you ain't getting out of this. Come here. I didn't think you could grab him through there. Yes, we must go another way. So let's go over this way.
I'm committing to this type of generator, my lord. You'll need to dislodge the service hatch to expose the dynamo inside.
The dynamo. We must expose the dynamo in the generator.
And so, our brave heroes travel to the ice planet of Hoth to reveal the dynamo.
Actually, that's a pretty cool word, actually. Dynamo. But anyway, there's the... Let's get rid of these guys first. Oh, man. The one guy's protected from lightning, but, well, he's not there. But not his buddy. Get him out of here. Here's the generator, so let's open it on up.
You should be able to see the dynamo. It's generating enough energy to deflect most attacks. However, if you were able to jam the dynamo with a large object of some sort, it should disable the generator. That would neutralize the force field.
Perfect. And what large objects can we use? We can use this box right here. Yeah, you can throw in one of these big boxes or a bunch of these little boxes to jam it. But as you saw there, lightning ain't gonna work on that thing. So let's throw this on in there. Perfect. Nice.
You've got it, my lord. The force field is down.
Progress has been made.
Well done, my lord.
Oh, did... Wow, that was not a very good attempt at trying to whack me with your rifle there, buddy. But anyway, yes, we can level up, even though we don't really, you know, there's really no need to. That's all right. Like I said before, we're having fun tossing the rebel scum around right here. Oh, throw a thermal detonator at me. You lost your ever-loving mind. Come here. Give these wampas what for here. Yeah, alright. Purple lightning for the win. Let's go through... Whoops. Let's blast through these doors here. And we have a sheet of ice on the floor here, so let's repulse and get on through it. Jump down. And right behind us when you jump down is Holocron number 2. Now we're going to have a whole bunch of rebels in this control room here. And let's do that there. Ah, yes, you can see the shield generators out there. And, you remember, I don't know, I'm distinctly having a, I'm having the strangest feeling of deja vu right now. Anyway, and if you're, by the way, if you're new to the channel and you don't know what I'm referring to a previous Let's Play there. But anyway, let's head on up this way here, and what we've got... Ah, excellent! The shield generator has been destroyed. So let's grab this unlimited energy holocron here. Ah! I don't know, sometimes I kind of feel bad for killing the rebels, but at the same time, we're on a mission. And they are trying to kill me too, so. Let's go through this door now. I love how we're at the point that we could just dash through doors like that. We've got Starkiller's come so far in his journey with the Force. Now, let's throw this guy out of the way. And let's go through here. Alright, what do we got? Oh!
We meet at last, son of Vader.
You're wrong. My father was a Jedi. Vader murdered him.
So you have been told.
Whoa, Luke Skywalker! In the flesh, there he is! And he's, Yeah, he's at the point now where he's a Jedi himself. But he is no match for the awesome might of Starkiller here. Yeah, you can whoop up on him here. He's just a boy. Obi-Wan can no longer help him. But yeah, pretty cool, pretty epic battle here. And he does have some moves that can, you know, they can do enough damage to you, so. But at the same time...
What do you want from me?
Oh, he just came back up. Okay. I was like, where did he go? Anyway. Yes, run, Skywalker, run! Uh-oh. We got trouble.
What was that, Commander Skywalker, my lord? The Emperor would prefer that you take him alive.
I'll bear that in mind, Lieutenant.
Yeah, keep your thoughts to yourself, Lieutenant. No, I'm just kidding. You don't worry about Skywalker. We'll worry about Skywalker. Anyway, I'm just gonna move past those wampas there. Sweet. Yeah, we're just gonna move on past those wampas there. And take a second and look at Starkiller's, like, utility belt there. Look at all the lightsabers that he's got. He's got his old one, he's got Coda's lightsaber. It looks like he's got, he's got Darth Vader's and, half of Darth Maul's there from when we fought Proxy. Very nice attention to detail there. That I did not notice before. Actually, I didn't notice it until recently, and I've played this game a whole bunch of times. But anyway, let's burst through the doors here. Ah, yes. Oh! Body pile!
No!
Yes, we've got a whole bunch of rebels in this control room here.
Imperial troops have entered the base. Imperial troops have entered.
Ah, good work, boys. Here they come. Here come the snow troopers. Yes. Just like old times. You know, it seems like it was yesterday. We were just one of those snow troopers having to destroy the shield generator. Now we're seeing it from a different perspective, but, anyway, right in here, if you destroy this, the yellow glass panel here, we have another holocron, number 3. Yeah, the ones in... Oh, that's one of our troopers. We'll set him down. But, yeah. The holocrons in this level are they're very spread out, and, you know, I guess they would kind of have to be, since there's only 5 of them in here.
He got me! Cover me!
Cool. I'll leave them, leave the fellas to deal with the rest of them there. And we'll go through the tunnel that they made right here. And we'll burst on through the... wait a minute. Hey, what's going on there? There we go. Wait a minute now. I said... Alright, Starkiller. Come on now. I said, get through that door. There we go. let's see. You guys are getting in my way. Get out of here. So let's take this conduit out. And hop on up in the tunnel. Whoop. Let's see here. Whoop. There we go.
Sir, a squad of stormtroopers from the 501st Legion have breached the corridor ahead.
Perfect. Let's go join the boys of the 501st there. Like I said, we were one of them once. And there's, yes, lots of rebels for the taking here. But yeah, nothing back here. And yes, good work, men. Now if we head off this way, there should be a little hallway off to the right. Right here, yes. There's a door you can push through to get holocron number 4. Yeah, there we go. Get rid of that guy and that guy, okay. We'll head on through here. And let's see. Uh-oh! The Wampas have broken free. Let's grab this. Yeah. And I think that other one, he probably went to go take care of the rebel boys there. The rebel rousers. Maybe? Oh yeah, they're gone. He got them goods. Let's burst through this door here. Oh, well, I guess the rocks shot first? I don't know. Anyway, uh-oh. That complicates things. Well, in any case, there's a detour off here to the left. You can push through the sheet of ice, and the final holocron of the level is right here. And, yeah, you pretty much are guaranteed to... Oh, whoa. Can you hop up here? Whoa, that's cool. No, you can do that. Yeah, the last holocron you're pretty much guaranteed to get, because you have to go through here to get to the other side. So, let's actually... Oh, block, Starkiller, block! There we go. That's what we want. You do not need to get clawed in the face by a Wampa here. Ah, here we go, out to this hangar here. And we've got...
There he is! Protect the princess!
The princess. Ah, Princess Leia. Wouldn't be the first time Starkiller had a run-in with her, actually. Yeah, no, it's weird to think about, like... all of these characters, like, in these bonus levels that we were coming across, but if you think about it, Starkiller has interacted with at least some of them. Like, in the, oh, perfect, invincibility. He's interacted with at least some of them, like, with the, or, like, in the main campaign. But, yeah, there's just a bunch of rebel troopers here, and I believe, for the most part, they're gonna keep respawning. So what we need to do is actually... run to the other side. Well, first I do want to get rid of any snipers like this guy, because they pose the biggest threat right now. So yeah, there's the grand old Millennium Falcon there, and we need to get to it. So let's throw that guy out of the way. Ah, and we've got two big generators, just like we saw before. Or, yeah, kind of like what we saw before, except they're twice as large now. And let's grab the health drain aura here. And the good thing about this is that we can... Oh, that's one of our snowtroopers. Let's put him down. Where are those rebels? We can toss rebels into him also. And yeah, there's enough items here to where you can... You can hear it kind of overloading there. All right, there's one. Now, the other one here. Where is... You know what would be really cool? Let's see. Yes. Grab a snow speeder when it emerges here and throw it right into the generator. Just like that. Rebels have thought ahead here. That's okay. Starkiller is gonna break his way in. Come on, man. Stretch them doors. Uh-oh. Uh-oh. We got resistance. Whoa.
I won't run from my destiny. Or from you.
Oh, boy. Oh, Luke's mad now. And, well, yeah, let's... do you? Yeah, we'll see, Skywalker. Very interesting. Very interesting, this Skywalker fella. He's, he can, well, yeah. Wouldn't it be something if he got so angry that, well... I don't know. Where did my saber go? There we go. Block my saber throw, foo! Oh, I thought I was hitting him there. Here, get out of here.
You're making me angry.
Uh-oh, hey, you put me down. You do not lift me in the air, sir. That ain't how that's gonna work, yeah. Saber lock you here. Yeah, throw you to the ground. All right, here we go. Let's see what happens to old Luke here. Ooh. Damn.
Now I will destroy you, Skywalker, as I destroyed your father.
No!
Uh-oh.
This ends now.
What the? Now what's up?
The Emperor should have sent someone stronger.
Whoa, no. Oh, no. Luke has fallen to the dark side. Oh, this is wild stuff here. Oh, and he's got red lightning. Yeah. This is, Oh, come on. You do the lightning again. I love it when they do the lightning, because I love being able to block it. But, and block it and throw it right back at him. But yes, fallen Luke. Yes, fallen Luke, now that he is, now that he's embraced the dark side, he is a lot stronger. So let's... Yeah, there we go. Blocked his lightning. He's got that damaging aura around him too. Uh-oh. Yes. Block, there we go. Send that lightning right back to him. Here we go. Now what happens? Oh, God, he's just getting beaten here. Oh, shoot, man. Oh, boy.
Strong Skywalker, but only your hatred will give you the power to save your friends. Give in to the dark side. Very good, my apprentice.
Whoa. And that, my friends, is the conclusion of Star Wars The Force Unleashed Ultimate Sith Edition, with Luke Skywalker becoming Starkiller's apprentice on the dark side. How about that? I will say, like, when I first saw that, I was like, what? That is so out there, but it's really freaking cool, actually. Yeah, I couldn't believe it. Was weird. I actually couldn't believe it when I first played this level, because I didn't know what was going to happen. Like, does Luke die? Like, does Starkiller die? What happens? But that was some crazy stuff right there. And with that concludes the LP. And gosh, I can't even believe I'm saying that. This game is. First of all, like I said at the end of the Death Star level, like when we did the light side ending, it's fun as hell. And, you know, if you're looking for a good, if you're looking for a Star Wars game with a good story, pick this one up and play it, because it's really, it's fun. But with that being said, it's not that long of a game, though. Like I said, there's 10 levels, including the prologue and the main storyline, and then you get the 3 bonus levels as part of, like, the Ultimate Sith Edition, which is the Jedi Temple level, Tatooine and Hoth, following the dark side ending of the game. Even though the light side ending is the canon ending to the game, even though the game itself is not canon because, we had a whole bunch of movies come out, but but you know. It's a great game, and I love it a lot. But I will also say that the other versions of the game have more levels in them. There's at least 3 Jedi Temple levels in, like, the Wii and PS2 versions. And like I said, you know, in that earlier episode, yeah, like, those versions are pretty limited graphically, but I do think they do a better job at telling the story of the game. But regardless, it's still a great game no matter what version you get, and whichever version you have easiest access to, then pick it up and play it. Hopefully Yes, I know I've had my fair share of glitches along this ride here, but I think as crazy as this is about to sound, it gives the game character, you know? It's like, I don't know. I appreciate this game for what it is, even though it has some flaws in it. And, you know, I did a Let's Play of it, so, you know, it's obviously I like it enough to where I wanted to play it. And as a matter of fact, I love it, but, yeah, I don't really have much else to say, so I just want to say thank you for watching, as always, and thank you for just being an awesome bunch of people here. And thank you for being an awesome person, you watching this here at home. This has been Lightning Bolt Forever, and this concludes Let's Play Star Wars The Force Unleashed Ultimate Sith Edition. When we come back, we will be playing something new. So until then, this is Lightning Bolt Forever, and I'll see you later. Bye-bye! Aha! Ooh, the shield generator. Whoa. Bam! Look at how... Did the game just crash? The game just crashed. Are you the game just crashed! What? The game crashed! Am I even still recording right now?